In this video, we're going to start the KutaSoftware Infinite Geometry free worksheet, sample spaces, and the counting principle. And you can find this worksheet within the Statistics and Probability section under that Geometry tab. For numbers 1 through 6, we're to represent the sample space using set notation. But what exactly is the sample space? Well, the sample space is a list of the possible outcomes, and we're just going to write that using set notation. So a squiggle bracket, we're going to list our possible outcomes, and then another squiggle bracket to close that set. So number one, it says that a sandwich shop has three types of sandwiches: ham, turkey, and chicken. So there's three possible outcomes. So using our set notation, we'll have ham as one choice, turkey as the other outcome, and chicken as our next possible sandwich. Those are the three types of sandwiches, or sandwich meats, listed in set notation. So that is our sample space. Let's move on to number two. In number two, it says the chess club must decide when to meet for practice. The possible days are Tuesday, Wednesday, or Thursday. So writing our sample space using set notation, there's three possible days, so three possible outcomes. Tuesday is one, and then we're going to put a comma and then write the next possible outcome, which is Wednesday. And then finally, the last possible outcome is Thursday. And then we'll close our set. In number three, it says the chess club must decide when to meet for a practice. The possible days are Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday, just like in number two. However, now there are three possible times for each of those days: 3, 4, or 5 p.m. So now our sample space has increased. So starting by opening up our set, now within our set we're going to need to use parentheses, because for Tuesday there's three possible times. That's 3, 4, or 5 p.m. So writing our first possible outcome is that the chess club meets for practice Tuesday at 3. So Tuesday, comma 3, and then we'll close that parenthesis. The next is that they can meet Tuesday at 4. And then finally, the last possible outcome on Tuesday is Tuesday at 5. So now there's three potential or possible outcomes for a Tuesday practice. Now we need to see the possible outcomes for a Wednesday practice. Same as Tuesday. We have Wednesday at 3. Then we have Wednesday at 4. And finally, we have Wednesday at 5. So far, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 possible outcomes. And now we need to take care of our last day, Thursday, where we can meet at three separate times on Thursday. And that's Thursday at 3, Thursday at 4, or Thursday at 5. And that finishes our possible outcomes, so we can close our set for sample space. So there are 9 possible outcomes: Tuesday at 3, Tuesday at 4, Tuesday at 5, same times for Wednesday, and then the same 3 times for Thursday. Let's move on to number 4. In number 4, it says, when a button is pressed, a computer program outputs a random odd number greater than 1 and less than 9. So that random odd number greater than 1 and less than 9 is either 3, 5, or 7. And it says that we press the button twice. So what are our possible outcomes? Opening up our set, pressing the button twice, we're going to have 2 numbers within a parenthesis. So let's say we get 3 the first time. The next possible outcome, if we push it again, we could get 3 again. Now let's say we push the button and get 3 as our first number. Then if we already pushed the button and got 3 for a second time, then we can push the button and get 5 as a second time. And then lastly, we push the button and get 3 for a first time, and we already got it 3 as a second time, we already got 5 as a second time, so 7 will be the number we could potentially get as a second time now. So if you get 3 on the first time, you can either get 3, 5, or 7 as a second press of the button. Now let's look at if we get 5 the first time. If we get 5 the first time, one outcome is that we get 3 the second time the button is pushed. If we get 5 first, we've already taken into account the time that we get 3, so we could get 5 the second time. And if we push 5 first, we've already taken care of getting 3 the second time. We've already looked at getting 5 the second time, but we could still get 7 the second time. So there's 3 possible outcomes when we get 5 as the first number. Now let's look at if we get 7 first. We could press the button and get 3 for the next time. We could press the button and get 5 the next time. Or we could press the button, get 7 the first time, and 7 the last time. So you can see there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 possible outcomes for number 4. In number 5, it says that a spinner can land on either red or blue. So our first options, either red or blue. So there's 2 different first choice options. So you spin, and then you roll a 6-sided die. So a 6-sided die, we could get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, or 6. Any of those possible numbers. So now we're going to look at what our sample space is. So what kind of combinations can we get? So let's say that we spin the spinner, and we get red. And I'll write R for red. Then we roll the die. Well, we can get either 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, or 6. So let's say we get 1. Now we'll spin again. Say we land on red again. Now we can get 2. Red, 3, red, and rolling 4. Spinning red, and rolling 5. And finally, our last option associated with spinning red first is getting a 6. And then we're going to do the same thing for blue. Say we spin blue first, then we can roll a 1. If we spin blue, then we can roll a 2. Spin blue, we could roll a 3. Blue, 4. Blue, 5. And blue, 6. And those are all of our possible outcomes. Spinning red and getting 1 through 6 on the die gives us 6 different options, and then spinning blue and getting 1 through 6 on the die will give us 6 more options. So in number 5, you can see there are 12 different possible outcomes. So there's 12 items within our sample space. And lastly, for this set of directions, number 6. It says that there are 2 boys and a girl on a trivia team. 2 questions remain. One team member is randomly picked to answer the first question, and a different member is randomly picked to answer the second question. So for the boys, I'll label them as B1, so boy number 1, and boy number 2, and the girl I will label as G. Now the important fact to note here is that the members are randomly picked the first time, and then the second time a different member is picked. So if the girl is picked the first time, she cannot be picked again the second time. So looking at our sample space, let's assume that boy number 1 is picked the first time. That means he cannot be picked the second time. So our next 2 options would be either boy 2 or the girl. So boy 2, or we can pick boy 1 and then the girl. Now let's look if we pick boy 2 first. If boy 2 is picked first, he cannot be picked again. So we will either get boy 1 or the girl. So our first option, we'll say, is boy 1. And then a second possible outcome is that boy 2 is picked first, and then the girl is picked second. And then lastly, we're going to look at when the girl is picked first. So if the girl is picked first, we can either have boy 1 picked second or boy 2 picked second. So the girl and then boy 1 is one outcome, and then the girl and boy 2 is another outcome. And then I'll close my sample space. And that is my answer in number 6. And quickly, I'll show you another way you can think about this visually. So for the first question, you can either get boy one, boy two, or the girl. And then we're going to draw a branch or tree diagram to show the next couple options. So if boy one is picked first, then we can either have boy two or the girl. If boy two is picked first, then we can either have boy one or the girl picked next. And if the girl is picked first, we can either have boy one or boy two picked second. And you can see that's the same thing I have in my set notation. B1 and B2, and then B1 and G. B2 and B1, and then B2 and G. And then finally, G and B1, or G and B2. So that's just another way that you can think of it visually. For numbers 7 through 10, we're going to be finding the number of possible outcomes in a sample space. Now quickly, I want to talk to you about the counting principle. The counting principle says that if there are m ways to do one thing, where m is a variable, so m ways to do one thing and n ways to do another, then there are m times n number of ways to do both. And number 7, a jewelry store sells gold and platinum rings. Each ring is fitted with a ruby, sapphire, emerald, or diamond gemstone. So first of all, there's two separate types of ring bases, essentially. So you can either have platinum or you can have gold. So there are m number of ways to make that base of the ring, and that's either gold or platinum, so that's 2. And then each ring is fitted with a gemstone, and the number of ways or number of different gemstones that you can have in that ring is ruby 1, sapphire 2, emerald 3, or diamond 4. So that's 4. Then m times n, number of ways to do both. So 2 times 4 will give us 8. So there are 8 different ways we can make a full ring. So for example, we could have a gold ring, fit it with a diamond. Or we could have a gold ring, fit it with a sapphire. We could also have a platinum ring, fit it with a diamond, or a platinum ring, fit it with an emerald. So if you go through each of the different possible outcomes, going through the entire sample space, you will get 8. Now let's look at number 8. We have that a spinner can land on either red, blue, or green. So that's 3 different possible outcomes, and it says we spin twice. Now this can be a little misleading because you would think that n would equal 2. However, it's the number of ways to do one thing, so there are 3 different colors in the first spin, and in the second spin, there are still 3 different colors. So m times n will be 3 times 3, which is 9. So our sample space is 9. So there are 9 different combinations if we spin twice. So number 9 is a bit different than 7 and 8. We have 8 rooms in a house that need to be painted. Each room can be painted either white or yellow. So each of the 8 rooms has 2 different options. So remembering our counting principle, there are m ways to do one thing and n ways to do another. However, this time, as opposed to 2, we're given 8, where we have a choice of 2 different colors or 2 options within those 8. So we'll have 2 different options for the first room times the 2 for the second room times 2 for the third room, 2 for the fourth room, 2 for the fifth room, 2 for the sixth room, 2 for the seventh room, and 2 for the eighth room. So that's 2 times 2 times 2 times 2, and so on 8 times. So we can simplify this as 2 to the 8th. And 2 to the 8th is equal to 256 different options that those 8 rooms can be painted. So thinking of one option, you could have all 8 rooms white. Another option, you could have one room white and the rest yellow. Another option would be to have half of them yellow and half of them white. And so on. There are 256 different options. Moving on to number 10, it says 6 books need to be placed on a shelf. You randomly arrange the books on the shelf from left to right. Since we have 6 books and we're arranging them randomly from left to right, that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So that's 6 different M or N values. So at first, out of the 6 books, we have 6 different options of which books to place first. For the second decision, there's only 5 books remaining, depending on what our first book was. So that's 5 options next. And then once we place that 5th book, there are only 4 books remaining. So that's 4 possible books next that we placed. And then after that 4th one is placed, there are only 3 left. So there are 3 ways to place those 3 books. And then there's only 2 left once you place that 3rd book. So there are 2 different ways to place those last 2 books. And then finally, there's 1 book remaining and only 1 way to place that book. So 6 times 5 is 30, times 4 is 120, times 3 is 360, times 2 is 720, and then we multiply that by 1 is 720. So there are 720 possible options for placing the 6 books from left to right on the shelf. And with that final answer, we wrap up this worksheet. If you have any questions, leave them in the comments below. And if you haven't already, like this video and subscribe to my channel. All likes and subscriptions are greatly appreciated, and let me know that you're finding these videos useful. Also, don't forget to share this with your peers.